In 1652, the King of Holland forbade intermarriage inside aristocratic families when his doctors discovered the anemia, hemophilia, and the other genetic weaknesses his noblemen were building into their bloodlines. But Eva Van Damme was a narcissist, one of the great ones. Unable to make love to herself, she settled on the closest satisfactory substitute, her own twin brother. When she heard the king's decree, Eva Van Damme packed up her family, her brother, cousins, nieces, and nephews, and transplanted them to the new world. She built a great mansion there. With the passage of time, the doors closed to outsiders, and finally the Van Damme family disappeared entirely from view.
Sure you're okay?
I'm feeling anxious. I'll be fine.
What's that over there?
Well, that's the county cemetery. There's big trouble there.
Really? Are those women?
Not a record.
What are they doing?
The county caught the owner, Bertie Gordon. That's her there. Using substandard wood in her coffins. Made a big political stink out of it. Forced her to dig them up, took away her contract. Bertie's always trying to cheat somebody out of something. The coffins are gonna be shipped back to the mainland for reburial. Bertie's mad as hell. afraid it's gone, lady.
It's okay. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. You low-down thieves. There ain't nothing wrong with them coffins. Besides, no one seems to be concerned or wants them.
I need a doctor, quickly!
Well, there's a kind of a doctor just arrived. Lives on the other side of the island. Hang on. Alice! We need your boat!
It's not the easiest way, but it's quicker.
Hey, where do you think you're going, girl?
Well, these people need the boat. They need help.
Get your ass back here, fast. You got work to do.
I'm so hungry.
I know. Help me get him up.
Like I may get some guests at the hotel. And with any luck, a burial plot, too.
Thank you. I'll pay you whatever you want.
Well, that's not necessary. Don't worry about it.
Lazy damn kid, cruising around a boat.
Guys, I don't like it down here.
Prepare the body for burial!
Lie down, Daisy. Play dead.
Who are you supposed to be? Birdie Gordon?
Formaldehyde, please.
Ben, you booger had it all over me.
What are you kids doing down there?
Nothing, Mrs. Gordon.
Uh-oh, we're in big trouble now.
Dr. Marlowe! Okay, hold on.
Dr. Marlowe?
Used to be. Not anymore.
Sorry, I don't understand. I was told that Dr. Marlowe lived here.
I am Dr. Marlowe. What's with him?
He's got blood poisoning, and I need BAL, dimer captopropanol. Do you have that?
Propanol?
I need a shot of it or he'll die.
Well, let's just relax. There you go. Are you sure he's not allergic?
No, I'm a nurse and we've treated him with it before. It's all right.
Could kill him.
It won't kill him.
What can you tell me about the disease?
It's a degenerative congenital blood disease. That's all we know. Don't know anything more about it.
You're from Paris.
He was raised in Paris, yeah, on an anonymous trust fund. It took a lot of digging, but we traced the fund back to the bank Bangor, and this birth certificate, it said he was born here on the island.
Strauss. It doesn't ring a bell.
We thought maybe he might have some relatives that lived on the island that knew about the disease or had dealt with it or tried to treat it.
Well, it's not impossible. I'd say good luck.
You know, for a doctor, you're really not very helpful.
Who says I'm a good doctor?
What about the doctor that signed the birth certificate, Dr. Asa Peterson? Do you know where I can find him?
He drowned on a fishing trip. Look, I've only been here for 2 months. I can't help you.
So you're just filling in here?
Yeah, just filling in. I used to have a clinic in Africa, Johannesburg. Small and simple. I even had my own plane. I didn't know the boss just wanted me out. So one day, after I landed a bit rough, I took away my license, said I had a drinking problem. I wasn't drinking then.
Jesus, you break into this coffin. What the hell happened to the body?
Sometimes has to settle itself. You'll get used to it.
Nothing to worry about.
Look who's coming back from the dead. which color you prefer.
How much do we owe you, Dr. Miller?
That's all right. It's in the house.
Thanks.
You have a place to stay?
No, actually, can you recommend a place?
I'll drop you off.
Okay.
Let's go. The hotel is right there. It's the only one there is.
Okay, thank you. I don't think I'm gonna like it here.
We won't be here long.
John? What is it? So much better. Mother figured you'd be staying, so she had your luggage brought over.
What is that smell?
Oh. Sorry. We're preparing the mortuary for Reverend Shay's widow.
We heard.
Hi.
Hi.
She was a real nice lady. Hey, did you hear about the coffins? Somebody's been breaking into them.
Yeah. Aren't there any men on the island?
Oh, they're all out with the fishing fleet. Except for my dad, Hank, because he helps my mother. How about the bridal suite?
Thank you.
It's strange being here.
Well, it's a place where you were born.
I know. Makes me anxious.
Oh, honey, that's completely understandable. How can you not be anxious looking for your family?
Stop being so understanding.
What are you looking for?
Phone book. Maybe the Strausses are listed.
There's no phone.
you keep your filthy eyes off him, baby Laura. Toot here, Sam, first.
Hi. Could you help us? Do you know if there's anybody named Strauss on the island?
My husband's very ill. We're trying to find his family here.
He's from the island?
The Strauss family?
I don't know anyone named Strauss.
I'm John Strauss. I'd really appreciate any help.
What's your accent? Is that Italian?
Maybe she could help us.
Baby Laura? Oh, she doesn't talk. She hasn't since she was six.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's not your fault, hon. Anyhow, I'm sorry I can't help you, but there's no Strauss family here.
Alice, stop dreaming and get back to work.
Those poor people, they have so much trouble.
Yeah, we'll just make sure they don't leave without paying their bill.
Mothers are not like that.
What the hell would you know? People are the same everywhere.
Hope not.
Well, hop to it. Little Shay's getting right down there.
I always really admired your hair, Mrs. Shea. It was always so neat and organized.
Alice, are you there?
Down here! I'm sorry.
It's the embalming fluid. I always smell of it for days after.
I was wondering if I could get a ride across to the other side of the cove with you.
I'm gonna be here a while with Mrs. Shea. Do you think you can handle the boat alone?
No problem. I grew up on the vineyard. It was mandatory.
The keys are in it, but be careful, because the weather changes real fast around here, and there's a storm warning out.
Okay. Thank you.
Please don't mention this to my mother.
Promise.
It's coral sunset, so I know it's not your color, but it's the only one we've got.
For Christ's sake, Alice, quit yakking at the stiffs. It's nuts. Step on it, Hank. You aren't gonna believe this.
Hi, Daddy.
Hey, Sugar.
Dorothea tells Hank Mrs. Shea wanted to be buried in her necklace.
What necklace? I never saw her wear that before.
Shit. Who'd have thought a reverend's widow'd have something like this stashed away? Where the hell'd she get it?
Family heirloom. Must be worth a fortune.
Oh, aren't you the observant one? Of course it's worth a fortune. Fortune's gonna end up 6 feet under, doing nobody no good. That's what I call waste. And Bertie Gordon don't tolerate waste. Get busy, I want her on the ground before it rains. We're burying her at the Van Dam Cemetery.
But the Van Dam Cemetery is private property.
Well, all the Van Dams are dead, so who's gonna stop us? Besides, the county's digging up our cemetery, right? And I don't want no more jerk officials nosing around in my coffins. Get back to work.
It does seem a shame, don't you think, Daddy?
Oh, I don't know, Princess.
Mother's gonna steal these jewels, isn't she?
No, of course she wouldn't do that.
Daddy, I couldn't tell this to anyone but you, but I'm gonna leave the island.
Oh, you wouldn't leave your old daddy, would you, Alice?
I'd send for you.
couldn't leave you, Mother.
You're just too good, Daddy.
I knocked. Sorry, no one answered.
Oh. How are you? How's John?
He's resting. I wondered if I could talk to you.
Sure, sit down.
Thanks. I just needed a sounding board, someone just to talk to.
Have some tea.
Thank you. The level of degeneration of John's blood is increasing, and his seizures are just getting worse. We've been to the best hospitals, and no one has any answers for us. Do you think that what John has is hereditary?
What do you know of the Van Damme family?
Nothing. Why?
They came to the island about 300 years ago. They were a rich Dutch family. There's lots of stories about them. I studied Dr. Peterson's files. He was into genetic research. He found some evidence of inbreeding. Inbreeding can cause mutations, genetic changes. One of them, which you may probably know, is dissimilar eye coloring, not unlike your husband. Or like this.
You think John might be a Van Damme?
Could be.
Well, how can I get in touch with them?
The last of them died 75 years ago. Dr. Peterson had a nurse. Her name is Lexi Krongold. You may want to talk to her. She still lives here.
Thank you.
Good neighbor to us. I sorely miss her. I remember her as a girl. Ah, ladies. Guess Mrs. Shea's gone to join the old pastor again. May she rest in peace.
Check on some things. Can I get something for you?
No, I'm good. Thank you. But thank you very much. Here's the boat keys.
Thanks. Thanks.
Have a good night.
Night.
Dr. Marlowe's, and he says that he thinks you might be related to the people who first settled on the island.
And he gave me the name of a woman who knows more information. Her name's Lexi Krongold.
We should go see her tomorrow, don't you think? Huh? That's good news, right? Finally, we're getting somewhere.
For what? Sorry, Mrs. Shea. I just need it for me and my dad to get away.
$2.75.
Once again, we get the bird.
Hey,
Be up here in a couple of hours.
What's the news from the fishing fleet?
The radio's down and I've been trying all morning.
Oh,
you haven't seen Alice this morning, have you?
No, actually, we were hoping she could give us a ride to the Krongold place.
What the hell for?
It's personal.
Damn, where's that girl? Well, I got business out there anyway. I could dig as far as the cliffs in my boat. It's about half a mile from there.
Thanks.
$25, take it or leave it.
$25.
We'll take it.
Smugglers way back when. Legend has it they used the caves and those cliffs to hide their loot. Nobody ever found any, though. Last of them died in a fire up there in their mansion about 75 years ago. That's where you're going.
Up there?
Yeah, that's where Lexi lives, has for years. She was a nurse. Oldest woman on the island. Lord knows what she does with herself way out there. She's an odd bird, that's for sure. Well, come on, I can take you part of the way. Follow me. It's a shortcut.
The subject is male, 33 years old. Blood shows preponderance of acanthocytes indicative of severe hemolysis. One second. It also shows marked similarities to the sample taken from the embryo, suggesting syndrome congenital, possibly inherited. Let's see. Where was I?
Doc, I think you better have a look at this.
What's that?
It's a griffin.
Doc. Appears to be human. Cause of death? Severe mutilation. Torso, well developed. Testicles fully descended. The damn thing just hopped off the pier right into my prop stock. Wait a minute. Now, superior to the penis, in an epidural fold, we discover a small, fully functional vagina. You're kidding. Seminal fluid present suggests a functioning hermaphrodite capable of having sex with itself. I need a drink.
Big man, a double.
Stop! Oh, I've been expecting you.
Miss Krungle?
You know me?
Oh, you're beautiful. Of course, I knew you would be a beautiful boy. Come here.
Is that really necessary?
Yes, it's necessary. Since they burned the estate, there's been all sorts of curiosity seekers, vandals. I have to protect the place, oh yeah. That's my job, don't you know? Come on now, boy. Come over here. Now, take off your shirt.
Why?
Go on. Open it up. I've got to look at that chest.
Dr. Marlowe said that you were Dr. Peterson's nurse.
Shh! Oh, yes. Yes, very nice. Oh, they're not so bad. Healed real good.
How?
Oh, you've every right to know. It's your story. It was the islanders burned down the mansion, killed off the whole family. Except for you. You know, Doc Peterson and I had to get you out of here. We had to send you away. Salvaged enough from that fire to set up the trust fund for you.
You know more than you're telling me. Why am I called Strauss, not Van Damme?
That's my favorite composer. Strauss. Oh, yeah. Now, look here, John. I saved something for you. Hmm? Look. These were attached to your tiny infant hands. So it was you made them scratches on your chest by clawing at yourself, poor baby.
These attached to my hands? Why?
Oh, Van Damme's did a lot of strange things. You've no cravings, am I right, boy?
I'm always craving something, but I don't know what. Can you explain it?
No.
If you know about my disease, tell me.
No.
No.
You better leave now.
Tell me what you know. You can help me.
No, I can't, boy. I can't.
If you know anything about my husband's
disease... No, I told you. Get the hell away from here.
After puncturing the stomach, pungent odor.
Oh. You smell it every day. It's embalming fluid, Doc.
There's more. He's got three stomachs. Hand me the jar.
Good idea.
be damned.
Callers, let him go. Meeny, miny, mo. My mother said to pick this one. You're it.
Ha! Oh, poo, I'm always it.
We're playing hide and go seek. Why don't you go hide?
John, they're all dead. There's nothing there for
us. It doesn't add up.
I thought I told us to leave.
This is my house.
Your house?
I'm a Van Damme. There might be something inside to keep me alive.
There's nothing in there for you, boy.
Then why are you protecting it?
I told you from vandals on account of the fire.
Which happened 75 years ago. I'm not 75 years old. You didn't pull me from that fire. Why are you lying? I'm dying. You say you saved me as a baby. Why won't you help me now?
My boy, go home.
If I was born after the fire...
Leave it be.
Then all the Van Dams did not die in the fire.
Death can be a sweet release. I'll show you.
Are you kids sure you weren't digging down there?
No honor! They caught her! They drowned her!
Are you sure you're not teasing me? There's no time for fooling here. Laura, go take the kids back to town before the storm hits. Okay, make sure you keep an eye on them. And Squeaky, you behave now. Help Laura, okay? We need help. Let's call the mainland PD.
This house that never burned down. It's made from ship's wood, you see. Soaked in brine, permeated with salt. Hey. There. Come on, this way. John. Van Damme still lived here when I was a girl. Nobody ever saw him. And one day I snuck in here to have a look. I saw him eating.
What did you see?
Well, the townsfolk set flame to the mansion, killed everybody. Thought they did. Truth is, some Van Dams escaped into the tunnels below this island.
They're still alive.
Phone's dead. Marine radio's down, so we're cut off.
Thank you.
that you saved me. Saved me from what?
From them. Because you were different. You were normal. I suppose in a way they were afraid of you. Still, it was a kindness, a kindness. Eva Van Damme.
You know what I'm craving, don't you? You have to tell me.
I can't. It's a secret. The great secret.
What is it, Doc?
It's a red blood cell from the autopsy specimen.
It's identical to the blood sample I drew from John Strauss and the embryo.
What's it mean?
Trouble.
Dr. Barlow, there's a terrible problem at the county cemetery. Little Ramona got dragged down some strange tunnel. We need all the help we can get. Hank, let's go.
Doc, you better take this.
Ramona?
Dr. Marlowe's. We have to find a way across.
No. Come on. Still down.
Try the phone?
Phones are down. We'll be out of touch till morning for sure.
Okay, so what are we really up against here?
There is something. The island is undercut by tunnels, all leading to the cemetery.
There are things living in them.
They are feeding on corpses.
Things? Well, what are they? Animals?
Mutations. Deformed people. What's left of the Van Dams? They survived the fire.
They eat human flesh.
Embalmed flesh. By removing the corpses from the island, you've taken away their food supply. Now, they're desperate, they're mad, and they're very hungry. They're coming after us. The good news is, they're extremely sensitive to light. Let's move to the lighthouse, everybody. We'll be safe there.
Flashlights, torches, lanterns!
Back and left.
okay?
Soaking in formaldehyde. That's what keeps them alive. I won't leave you. Please don't leave me.
Thank you.
Laura had a whole new set of senses.
Thank you.
please.
No, John.
Hey, where are you?
Fine, I'm just tired, that's all. I don't know what to do with that, John. I don't know what to do.
I'm sure you'll do what's best.
And so it came to pass that John was reunited with the Van Damme family. And he found that he too had a twin. And although his sister could make love to herself, she welcomed her long-lost brother. And loved him too.